Good morning, students of class 6. Today we are going to learn about the religion Jainism. Okay, so Lord Mahavir, Vardhaman Mahavir, was the founder of Jainism religion. Okay, he took born near Kundalvan in Vaisali district. Okay, in 540 BC. Like Buddha, he also led his earlier life in luxury. Yes, and he left his home at the age of 29. So, like Buddha, Vardhaman Mahavir also passed his early life in luxury. Okay, in palace. He, Vardhaman Mahavir, was also son of a Kshatriya. Okay, chief. He also belonged to Shakya clan. Yes, so both led their earlier lives in great luxury in palaces. Yes, but like Buddha, Mahavir also left his home at the age of 29. Yes, so there are the similarities between the life of these two important thinkers in 6th century BC. And after leaving his home, he also wandered here and there for 12 years. Yes, he also faced many difficulties, hardships in this journey, and he meditated for a long time. Yes, and thus he attained Kaivalya. It means he knew what is the truth. He attained the knowledge, and after attaining the Kaivalya, he became Jina. Yes, and the followers of Mahavir became the Jain. In this way, Jain religion was founded by Mahavir. Okay, like Buddha, Mahavir also attained the knowledge, and like Mahavir got Nirvana after getting the knowledge, Mahavir was he was said that he attained Kaivalya. So only the words are different, Nirvana and Kaivalya, but the meaning is same, that they both attained the knowledge. Okay, so in this way we have discussed that how this religion was established. Now we are going to learn about the Tirthankars. Tirthankar means the seeker of truth. Yes, and we all know there are 24 Tirthankars in Jain religion. The first one is Rishabdev, and the 23rd is Parshvanath, and 24th is Mahavir. So the last guru, the last Tirthankar was Lord Mahavir. Yes, after that when he acquired the knowledge, he also decided to spread his teachings among the people, and that's why he selected the language of common people, that was Prakrit. So like Buddha, Mahavir also preached in the language of common people, that was Prakrit. Yes, so that everyone could understand what he actually trying to say, what he actually wanted to convey the message to the people. Okay, and he gave his message to in the areas of Rajasthan, we can say Gujarat, Malwa in Madhya Pradesh, and in South India. In North India also he preached his message in Magad. Yes, that is Pataliputra. Yes, so in North and South he preached his messages, and unfortunately he died at the age of 72 near Rajgir, in Rajgir, Bihar, at Pavapur. Okay, and later on his teachings were compiled in 12 poems. Yes, so 12 poems are the literary sources by which we can know the teachings of Lord Mahavir. Okay, like Buddhism, Jainism also split into two parts. Yes, the first one is called Shvetambar and the second one is called Digambar. Shvetambar, those who joined this group, they used to wear white cloths, and those who followed Digambars, they did not put any cloths on their bodies. So they just treated the sky and the earth as their cloths. Okay, so we can say they did not use any cloths on their body, so they were called Digambars. Yes, now the main teachings of Mahavir. Mahavir, what Buddha said, many of the teachings of Buddha are similar to the teachings of Mahavir. Yes, Mahavir also rejected caste system. Yes, he also stressed on the equality of all people. Yes, he was against the rituals, ceremonies and expensive sacrifices. Yes, so this was the teaching of Lord Mahavir. He was also against the violence. So like Buddha, he also stressed on non-violence. He also stressed not to speak lie. Yes, he was also against the practice of like stealing something. Yes, so all these teachings that was proposed by Lord Mahavira were given by Lord Buddha also. Okay, so in both these religions there are many similarities. Tri Ratna is a word, a term in Jainism. It means right action, right knowledge and right faith. Right faith, right knowledge and right action, these are the three ratnas, jewelries, like three gems of Buddhism. Yes, he also proposed these things, that if we have the true knowledge, if we have the true faith, if we are doing the right things, then a person is good. Okay, so he also stressed on the importance of work. Okay, or action, or the things that we do. Suppose any person who has taken birth in lower caste, according to Mahavir, it is according to his deeds of his earlier life. Okay, and he believed that these kind of people also can get moksha if they attain the truth, the knowledge. Okay, and if they wear the three ratnas, these kind of persons can also get moksha, that is free from the cycle of birth and death. So these were the teachings of Mahavir. Okay, now the next topic is similarities between Buddhism and Jainism. So what are the similarities between these two religions? Just we have discussed that both these thinkers took birth in 6th century in the same region. Okay, the origin of place, origin of birth, sorry, where they took birth, the place is the same, that is Magadha, we can say. They both later luxurious life in the beginning. They both left their home in the early age. Okay, and they meditated in the same way. They attained the knowledge. Okay, they also gave the message in the language of common people. Okay, they were against the caste system rituals. That's why these two religions are called the religion of protest, because they were against the caste system, they were against the expensive rituals, sacrifices, they were against the violence. That's why these two religions are called religion of protest. So we have just discussed the similarities between the teachings of Mahavira and Buddha. Okay, so these were the similarities between these two religions, and that's why they spread it and they were followed by the people at that time. Okay, so thank you, have a nice day. In the next video we will talk about the left topics of this chapter.